Hello. In this video, we will learn about zero order elimination kinetic. First, we will quickly revise first order kinetic. Then we will learn about zero order kinetic. And finally, we will see the graph of plasma concentration against time. Let's get started. First, let's quickly revise what we saw in the video of first order kinetic. This is plasma. This is drug. And these are the enzymes that degrade the drug. At present, plasma concentration of drug is low. So less molecules come in contact with enzymes, so rate of elimination is slow. If more drug is given, the concentration of drug increases. Now more drug come in contact with enzymes, so rate of elimination increases. Thus, in first order elimination kinetic, rate of elimination is directly proportional to plasma concentration of the drug. If we keep increasing the drug concentration, a point comes where enzyme system gets saturated. See, all the enzymes are working at full capacity now. At this point, rate of elimination reaches to its maximum. Further increase in plasma concentration no longer increases the rate of elimination. So once the elimination process gets saturated, rate of elimination remains constant irrespective of plasma concentration. Such kinetic is called zero order elimination kinetic. Very few drugs follow zero order kinetic. One example is ethyl alcohol. Its elimination system gets saturated quickly. So it follows zero order kinetic at virtually all the plasma concentrations. However, for most of the drugs, elimination process is not saturated over their therapeutic range of concentrations. So most of the drugs follow first order kinetic. Moving further, you must have heard this. In zero order kinetic, constant amount of drug is eliminated in unit time. Well, it means the same thing but with different words. Here 6 drug molecules are being eliminated every minute. This amount remains constant even with changing plasma concentrations as long as the drug is following zero order kinetic. Thus we can say constant amount of drug is eliminated in unit time. Now let's see the graph of plasma concentration of drug against time. In zero order kinetic, it's linear. This is because fixed amount of drug is being eliminated in unit time. So the graph we get is straight line. Now the final point. Plasma half-life is not constant in zero order elimination kinetic. Let's compare half-lives for these two different points to understand this. From this point, half concentration is this. Time required for 50% fall in this concentration is this long. From this level, half concentration is this much. Here the time required for 50% fall is shorter. For different concentrations, plasma half-life is different. Thus, plasma half-life is not constant in zero order elimination kinetic. This covers all the points for the video. Let's have a quick summary. Drugs follow zero order elimination kinetic if their elimination process gets saturated. Here, rate of elimination is constant irrespective of plasma concentration. A constant amount of drug is eliminated in unit time. Plasma half-life is not constant in zero order kinetic. And finally, plotting plasma concentration against time gives a straight line. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe Nonstop Neuron, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.